So, Mr. Farhan, I have a question. As we all know, ladies and gentlemen, that he was Dr. Abdul Qadir who gave us the power of atomic bomb. Atomic bomb. It means the gas, liquefied atomic bomb. And he was Dr. Abdul Kalam Azad, APJ Abdul Kalam Azad, who gave the atomic power to India. And Iran is also trying to make that such. So this is my question, Mr. Farhan. Why they made atomic power? To bring the peace or to destroy the people or to destroy the nation, those who are living in the other countries? This is my first question. And then I want to ask a question to you, that who started the system of hanging someone, that by the system of punishment they used to hang someone? And who system, this is my second question, that who started the hanging system? And then third question, that who gave the system of sati? Do you know sati? Whenever a husband die with it, they botting it's a burn living alive wife with her. So with him. So this is my question, that who gave the system of sati, hanging system?
Clap for.
Okay, so I'm going to answer Mr. Waquas. He has asked three questions. The first one is that he is saying that who created the bombs and these things. I want to tell you that, you know, this is the world. My topic is that they are mannered. It is not, obviously, this is a world, and in this world, different kind of people they are living. Obviously, there will be the dispute, there will be the fightings. And you see that these things are just order to defense oneself. For example, if a country is you know, trying to attack us, then for that we must be defended. We must have some, you know, bombs to defend ourselves. So this is nothing but the defense of oneself. Second one is hanging. You see that this punishment in the world, this has been started not only from the people but also from the religious. From our you know, Muslim point of view, there are some cases in which you can hang the person if he has done, like he has raped someone or he has killed someone. So you see that these are the punishments not created by the common man. Even from the religious, it has been coming. From the epic, it has been coming punishments and these things. Third one is that you are discussing about sati, that they burn the husband and wife together. So this is nothing but the height of arrogancy. This is nothing but the height of illiteracy. So I would like to tell you that this doesn't prove that animals, they are, you know, very much mannered. In some cases, even if you say that animals also eat other animals. So similarly, this is nothing. So in the cases, animals also in the jungle, in the forest, animals also kill one another. So if human beings are doing this doesn't prove that they are not mannered. Okay.
So, ladies and gentlemen, now I am going to play a voice, a video, a audio for you. Okay, so please try to listen it first. Then I will explain it.
अभी कोई दस्तूर होता है.
वो
सुना है जंगलों का भी कोई दस्तूर होता है. सुना है शेर का जब पेट भर जाए तो वो हमला नहीं करता. दरख्तों की घनी छाओं में जाकर लेट जाता है. हवा के तेज झोंके जब दरख्तों को हिलाते हैं तो मैना अपने अंडे छोड़कर कौवे के बच्चों को मैना अपने बच्चे छोड़कर कौवे के अंडों को परों से थाम लेती है. सुना है घोंसले से कोई बच्चा गिर पड़े तो सारा जंगल जाग जाता है.
वाह.
सुना है जब किसी नदी के पानी में बए के घोंसले का गंदमी साया लरसता है तो नदी की रुपहली मछलियां उसको पड़ोसी मान लेती.
ओफ, रुपहली मछलियां
उसको पड़ोसी मान.
सो गाइस, दिस वाज एन ऑडियो बाय व्हिच आई वांट टू टेल यू दैट हाउ मैनर दीज एनिमल्स आर. सो ट्राई टू इफ यू हैव हियर दैट ऑडियो देन यू कैन टुडे judge that how mannered they are. The lion, whenever it bellies, it or abdomen, it what we get, tummy get full, they never attack on the people. They never attack on any even animal of the creature of the goat. Now think about us, what we are doing. What we are doing and how many people we have killed, how many people Hitler killed, how many people died in what killed in during the partition of 1947, how many people murdered themselves. And we must not forget we are those animal, sorry, we are those social animal, or we are those human, we those who destroyed the Ottoman Empire of Turkey. Turkey means the human being killed, destroyed all the Ottoman Empire of Turkey, Saudi Arabia, Kuwait, and many of the Islamic countries. So guys, today, now I want to come on the science. I want to tell you the real innate behavior of the animal. There is the innate behavior. Innate behavior means the pre-programmed behaviors those animals have in their mind and how much wise they are. First is the taxis, single taxis. Taxis means towards the direction. The scientists, the researchers have said that the moth is a small insect which goes toward the light, So this is the wisdom of the moth. It knows that, for example, this is a light. This is the light and this is a small, what you can insect, a moth. Moth goes toward the light. It is its wisdom and it is my answer that how much wise they are. And it goes toward the light, it means that this is a positive taxis. And when it goes away from the darkness, that is negative taxis. Okay, so this is the wisdom they have. And now try to see this picture. What this picture is describing here. There are the three goats. Huh? Do you know this picture is giving us three hints. One is unity, second one is strength, and third one is wisdom. It's how united they are, you can see that. Do you know what is this? This is the Karunjar mountain of Nangar Parkar, which is even difficult for the human to climb that such. But these are the animals which have climbed that. By their strength, it means that they have strength. We must not neglect that thing. This is the real fact, this is the truth. And second one is unity. In unity, they have climbed the mountain. And third one is the wisdom. According to wisdom, how they are using the wisdom? By their wisdom means there's need to make the passes or routes to go that on the top of the mountain. So by that wisdom, they have climbed that. And do you know unity? Unity is the principle of Qaid-e-Azam Muhammad Ali Jinnah. Among the three principles, unity, faith, and discipline. It means that they are following unity, yes or not? They are following unity. But what about us? Are we following? No, we are not following. We are even killing the people. We use FIRs against people. Husband slaps her wife. But what they are doing? They have the unity, strength, and wisdom they use there. And then second innate behavior of the animal. Operant condition, trial and error learning. That is the secret which is the mice. Mice, have you ever heard mice? Kuo. Mice. Scientists did the experiment. It put the mice in the box and used the liver, and on the top of the box there was the meat. It hanged the meat there, and it saw that a mouse after many trials, it touches the button. When it touches the button, the food was coming down. That is the wisdom which the scientists have proved, David. Now the third one. Third one is insight learning, reasoning. That is the thing which is given us by the scientists. They say that chimpanzees. Have you ever heard chimpanzees? Chimpanzees are species of the monkeys. Monkeys. They saw that whenever in the enclosure, when we gave the boxes to the monkeys, these chimpanzees, and hang the bananas on the trees. What the chimpanzees were doing, do you know? They collected the box one by one and they were putting on them and they were climbing on them. By climbing, they got the bananas out of that tree. And that is the innate behavior. That is it. So now, Mr. Farhan, what will he say? He will say that this is the nature, this is the habit God has given him. And he will say that the people...
Thank you.
Listening these stupid audios and these science crossing my head, would like to tell you that I won't say that this is the nature of animals or insects to do these things. I will prove you that these all things, they are nothing but the loggerhead. Only loggerhead people or fool people will understand these things. Come here. We'll tell you that this is the bulb. This is a bulb, Mr. Waquas?
Yes.
Okay. This is a moth. That is an insect. I will tell you that this little insect is understanding that this is the kind of food that I will get, or this is a kind of orange or like a food that I will get. That's why that insect travels to a bulb, and when it hit the bulb again, it hit the bulb and after 10 to 15 times it hit the bulb but it still get nothing, and then it returns back. So this is its, you know, foolishness that insect is thinking that this is a kind of food. So these insects, these animals, they are nothing in front of us. I'm not denying the blessing of God that God has given us in the form of animals. They are, you know, they support us merrily. But I admit this, that men, they are not, you know, meaner than animals. Okay, so now I would like to tell you that I will make you watch a video that is about the training and the taming of animal by the human beings. You see that, here I will make you watch the video. That is, a man is taming the bear, the wild and beast bear. If you see, if you watch this. Kodiak bears are one of the largest species in the world. This is the wisdom. Okay, you see that this is a man that is taming and training the wild beast. So you see that this man is teaching the behaviors, this man is teaching the manners to the wild beast. You know, wild beasts, they are like the babes of wood. They don't know anything else. They, you know, bear in that place and, you know, die in that place. And they don't learn anything from anything else from their lives. So in the nutshell, I will tell you that animals, they don't have any purpose. And the life without purpose is a purposeless. And I will call you that life without purpose, without life is nothing. So Mr. Waquas should admit this, because he is himself a human being, and he must know that I am more, you know, wise than the animals. One thing I'm going to tell you, that he said that Farhan will say that this is the nature of animals, that they do these things. I will not say that this is the nature of animals. I will say that this is the emotions that bring themselves for the food, for the sake of food they climb the mountains. This is not their unity. They get united with each other because they are selfish, and they are doing this thing for the search of food, and this is food, and searching the food, and this is not the wisdom. This is the emotion that every living organism has been given. So you cannot say that this is the wisdom. This is not the wisdom. And second thing I want to tell you, that animals, they are very much manners include the cleanliness. And if you don't have if you are not clean, then I personally will not call him the mannerful. And I will show you a picture. That is, if you see this picture, this is the reality of animals that I'm gonna make you watch. See, these are the dogs in the town that are, you know, sitting in the gutters, a place where the entire feces and dirt gathers. And you see that these animals, they are sitting there. If you see this. So how can you call these living organisms mannerful? They are mannerful? No. And if you just know yourself, yeah, just know yourself. Who are you? This person. You are wearing the good clothes. You are from the good, families. And you are very much clean. So how can you compare yourself with animals? How can you say that animals, they are more mannerful than you? And third thing I want to tell you, that animals, they are very much selfish. On the other hand, we, you know, human beings, we are not selfish. We help each other. And I will play an act for you guys. Mr. Dasas, please. Oh my God! What happened to you? What happened to you? Oh my God, this is a serious injury. I must call doctor. First of all, please fetch water for him. First of all, drink the water. Now, please breathe. Please. And, oh, this is a very serious injury. I must do something for it. Okay. Now, please breathe and stand up. Please take care of yourself. When you are walking, you must see that if there is any stone, you must, you know, take this stone aside from the road. So, please take care from yourself. And, okay. So you see that human beings, they are, and on the other hand, if it were an animal, and that is, you know, that animal is wounded, and if any other, you know, animal passes from that, it will not help him. It will eat him. If it is not dead, it is wounded. It will eat that animal. And I can even prove, if you watch video on YouTube, then you will see that even the animal is, you know, eating the wounded animal. So how can you compare yourself, your superior being, with these animals who are selfish? If there is a dog.
Thank you.